Well, I feel horrendous, if I'm honest. I had three large poos, no point in lying about that. Yeah, I don't have no idea what I'm doing.
Oh dear, something's happened. They're going to have to cancel it, Chris. We've got to go home. Oh, what a shame. I was really up for that as well.
Horrendous. Actually, he was very kind to me. I owe Chris a beer. I thought he was going to kill me. I really did. And he had every right to, because of our past. So I've got a lot more respect for him, both with his ability of what he does, but also the fact that he didn't kill me. So now it's my turn to have a go in it. So I will return the favour.
Did it feel like you expected it to?
It just felt faster when it accelerated. But it was weird because he took his first lap going steady, but when he accelerated, it just takes off. I guess you're lying on the ground essentially. Feels twice as fast as it does on a bike. I got arm pumped. As soon as he accelerated once, I went from having no arm pump to having full arm pump. So I'm just thinking, I wish I could have that corner speed on two wheels around like Shell Oils, somewhere like that. It's incredible. But luckily, I've been told what to do with my feet, so I use my feet a lot so I could relax my arms. Got a different, I mean it, different respect for Chris, but like I said, not only they're a lot harder than they look to ride, but the fact that he could have had me out the back. I don't believe I'm going to say this, I think you might have grown up. I think you might have, finally, the old Chris.
Don't tell him that.
Chris, you'd have definitely had me out the back of there, wouldn't you? In the olden days.
Definitely a decade ago, without a doubt. No, I mean, these things, they're so different to solo. You have to have a lot of respect. I had 3 days in France to learn how to do what you've just tried to do in 3 laps. And that way they touch every bit of tarmac and dart around and move. And so if you've got all that to deal with as well as holding on, and as a passenger, you feel it as much as the driver, which I didn't realise till just now. And, you know, you came down Deer's Leap and you weren't really going that fast. And I went from like getting, you know, hanging right over to the right to trying to tuck in, missed that. And I tried to grab at the back of the seat and there's no handle there.
Yeah.
And then I managed to get another arm, and that's without you really pinning it.
Exactly.
So God knows what it's like when you're really on the pipe. I brake quite hard a couple of times so you could feel the sensation because the phenomenal braking.
Yeah.
Compared to a solo.
But you know, when you brake hard, what I did, I just used my head. I didn't let go of anything to tip my weight. I just used my head. I don't care. This is the worst passenger in the history.
Are we going to race you against each other one day? What?
I've a long way to go. No, you've got a head start on me. I'm too competitive. You destroy me. Because I know how slow that is to what they do. So.
Yeah, I mean, when you.
I'm not going to commit because I know we're being filmed. So I'm not committing because if I commit on camera, you'll be like, hey, we've got it. We've got it down.
you know, at fast enough to still get the chair wheel in there, that cascade, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, yeah.
You can feel it floating out. Yeah. And when I'm going race pace, I've never really felt that, because that's just riding, sharp is mega, just keeps the groove down. And with you sat in a little bit more, it came up easier.
Yeah.
So it's nice to feel that. Yeah. Nice to be back in it in a few weeks.
Yeah, cheers, Chris.
Thank you.
Thank you.